So anyway, I just thought we'd have a little fun and get started finishing up some pieces. I might jump around a little bit. I don't have a whole lot of time on here today, but I thought I got an hour or so. So if you want to hang out and have fun painting with me, I'd love to have you here. Sorry, I'm just getting set up. So, yeah, watercolor is kind of a temperamental beast, if you ask me. I like it. I just have to be in the mood for it. I prefer my alcohol inks. And those are temperamental too. I don't know what it is with me and temperamental. But I like those temperamental paints. I'm glad you're here. Thanks, Christina. And if you have questions about what I'm doing, I'm trying to monitor the comments from my laptop. So I love painting in acrylic. I find that less challenging. I started in oils probably, oh, 25 years or so ago. I used to just be one of those kids that drew all the time. I either had my face in a book or a notebook. So I was one of those kids that did a lot of painting, just with, those little cheap watercolors that you get at the store. Then I joined the military and spent a few years traveling around doing that. And now I am retired and my kids are all grown and I have lots of free time on my hands. So acrylics are very budget friendly. Though I like, I was on live Saturday, I think it was Saturday. I'm working on a eagle, and it's a on a very large, like 5 foot canvas, and it's done in oils. I underpainted it in acrylics and then went back and it sat for a while because I just hadn't had a chance to get it done. So I had quite a bit of work to do on it, and so I spent a couple hours live working on it. So, all right, so I had missed a couple of places on my sky when I did this watercolor, so I'm gonna try to fix it. I don't know if I can. But we're going to give it a shot and see if I can kind of blend that out into the background a little bit. See how that goes. And yeah, oil paints. I love working with oil paints. Like I was saying, I use water-soluble oil paints, and so those I like so much because they don't stink up my house. I don't feel like I have to open up every window and all of that because of the mineral spirits or turpentine, all that kind of stuff. But these, yeah, I really do like using the Windsor Newton brand for my oil paints. Okay, so I don't know what color blue this is. It's a, let's see here, what do they call it? They call it the sky blue. And it's pretty transparent, as you can see. I'm putting it on here pretty thick and then coming back with the water. I mean, you really, it's hard to mess up watercolor, but yet at the same time, it shows every mark, every stroke of the brush. So the big key with doing the watercolors is just to make sure you come in with plenty of water and kind of blend it out, or it will leave marks. But the good part of it too is I can come back in with a magic eraser or a wet brush and I can lift out. I like the texture that I get, so I'm not too fussy, especially when it's just these little abstract backgrounds. I wanted that sky just a tad bit darker in a few places, just because I really want this cute pelican to pop. My sister and I went to Corpus Christi back, oh gosh, probably a little over a month ago, and it was beautiful down there, and we got to see these pelicans just flying around everywhere, and we were right across from the marina, so we took a walk down there and saw all these cute, I say cute, I love pelicans. I grew up in the South in Mississippi, and the brown pelican was everywhere, and so that just made it really fun to see these that day. Yeah. So, okay, I'm gonna let that dry a little bit and see what it looks like. This particular one, no ma'am, I'm just, this is going to be based off of the pelican that I took a photo of down in Corpus. So, I've been to Louisiana many, 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 many times, and Louisiana, Mississippi, and parts of Alabama all have these swampy areas where you do get to see a lot of the pelicans, the brown pelicans. And then I was really kind of surprised when we were in Corpus to see so many down there, and I'd never seen them before. So that was really fun. So, and I may take a big wash brush and add more color to the sky, just to give it a bit more uniformity, since I did kind of mess it up by not having the darks and everything where I needed them to be when I first started, when I did it, when I first started the painting. So I think I need to have more coffee this morning. I hope I'm making sense. So, you know what? I had my brother, who passed away 2 years ago, had Down syndrome. So I grew up with someone who was on the spectrum, and then my daughter, she is on the spectrum as well, and so I have what's the word I want? I have a lot of experience with that. So bless your heart. I hope that things are good for you. I have a few friends that have children that are autistic as well. So I got a dog hair here. I have two dogs, and my daughter brought her big GSD over this past weekend to hang out with me while she went off camping with some friends. And so I'm finding I have these huge long hairs everywhere from her dog. So great. But I have four children. The oldest is 36, and the youngest is 24. And then I have three grandchildren. One is 14, and the other two are 1 year old. They just celebrated their 1 year birthday, born a week and a half apart from each other. So thank you about my brother. I appreciate that, Christina. He is dearly missed. He was a huge part of my life. I helped caregive for him before he passed, and so he's quite missed here. But so thank you for that. So let's see here. I think I'm liking how that's looking a little bit, but I still may change it up some more. Just don't want to get the paper too wet. So the technique I'm doing is wet on dry, not wet on wet, because I don't want to have to use the hair dryer to dry the paper flat again. So I think I'm going to leave that the way it is and go to work a little bit on the body of the pelican. And so I think I should have pulled up. Hey, Robert. Thanks for joining. Let's see here. See if I can pull up my photo. On my laptop real quick. Oh yeah, okay. That's what we need. Okay. So we're gonna do kind of a grayish blue on this underside down here. It's gonna get So the sun was directly overhead on this pelican when I took the photo. So he is going to be lighter on top. There'll be more highlights along the top of his head and the top of his beak. It's going to be rather dark and very dark under here because he's actually kind of, his fur was kind of hanging over the edge of this, what do they call it? The dock posts. I'm going to just go in here right now with a little bit of this mixture, this gray blue that I just put in. The gray blue that I'm using some of that sky blue mixed with the gray, which is Payne's gray, which is a kind of a nice blue gray already. I just like to add in using colors from the areas that I've already painted. It just helps to keep some uniformity and keeps the just helps the eye when you're looking at it. So I'm not going to be like leaving a whole lot of brush strokes. I'm just tapping in the color and letting it spread. What happens is it gets a texture to it that mimics the fur or the feathers, so that I don't have to do a whole lot of work. Just lay the paint in. I prefer the easy way. Let's see, I'm gonna darken this up a little bit more along the tippy top here. Thanks, Robert. I appreciate that. So what have y'all been up to today? Anything fun, special? Did you have a nice weekend? A lot of people out there celebrating St. Patty's Day. Alexa, play country music.
The station, Country Heat Radio, on Amazon Music.
Okay. More of that darker gray, a little bit of that sky blue. It almost gives it some purpley blue undertones to it, which, I mean, our shadows, if you were to really look, they're more blues and purples and not really black. Doing this, is really going to tell the eye, oh yeah, there's some dark shadows under here, and make it just feel more right, I guess is the word. I'm not very good at explaining it, but I think you get what I'm saying. Oh, painting the house. We did that a few years back. No. Okay, got it. Good. I have arthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, and so sometimes holding onto a brush is a challenge. So if you see a brush fly, it's because my hand decided to spasm and send it across the room, which has happened many, many times. So, anyway, painting the house is always fun, right? Okay, here I'm just adding in some kind of just little feather strokes on the end back here, just to imitate the fluff that would be. And I'm breaking up this line where I I drew it just to break it up a little bit and give some of the indications that this fluff carries off, you know, off of his body or her body. I really think it was a female that I took the picture of, because there was this beautiful, majestic male across from her, and he was twice her size, and he was sitting on another post, and so yeah, they were both just enjoying the day, it seemed like. So, all right, so I've got some shadow here. You can't see where I have marked some shadow, but I'm going to come in here and follow my guidelines that I put down and just put some of that same gray in here and come back in with my water and just kind of move that paint around a little bit. And it's a grayish blue, not really black, but just enough to give some indication that there's a shadow right there, and still keep my teal color. So I have this beautiful teal, green color. Come back in here and do just a few little places over the top of this green that I had added, just to give it that brightness. That algae that was growing on it was super bright and super just saturated in color. It was so pretty. I'll have to, when I post this up, I'll have to post up the picture of the original image that I took. I think you guys would get a kick out of it. Migrating to Colorado. I didn't know they went beyond the southern borders where it stayed warmer. That's interesting. Summer. That's cool. I've been to Colorado in the summer, but I never saw. Of course, I was up in the Estes Park area the last time I was there. I went to, so let's see, how many years ago would this be? 1985? 85 or 86, I was stationed out at Lowry Air Force Base, went to school out there for a year, and So weekends we would truck up to Estes Park and hang out and camp and things like that. And you know, what's a bunch of 17, 18 year olds going to do other than go camping when, you know, can't drink or anything like that? Back then I was a pretty wild child. I don't ever recall seeing that. But then, you know, it again was in the higher elevation, so I probably would not have seen them there. Okay. I think my light's a little bright on here. There you go. That's a little better for you to see without all that bright light. Okay. And a little light gray. And it's got a bit of a brown tone in that. Oh yeah, there we go. Okay, so I'm gonna go here. Just putting a little bit of this gray brown underneath where the wing is covering part of his body. And then we're going to go in here and add some more of that brown, or that gray blue. Oh, was he? That's cool. I was just there for school. My training school was there, and years later, my husband and I went back and took our youngest on a what do you call it? It was her graduation gift. She had always wanted to go, and so we took her. She's a photographer, and she she drove us crazy chasing her down through. What do you call it? The valleys up there in the mountains, because she was trying to chase after pictures. You know, she'd been waiting for years to go up there so she could take pictures of the moose. And I think her daddy and I about just had a coronary, because she was right there with us, and the next thing we know, she's gone. And we realize that she had gone down into the valley and was hiding behind some rocks to take pictures of this grouping of moose and their young, which was so not cool of her to do to her parents. Very dangerous, and she, of course, got the what for, but she just is one of those photographers. I worry sometimes, because she takes risks, and it can be dangerous. So, yeah, I love Colorado. It's beautiful there. I know I paint very different from a lot of artists. We all kind of have our own style, don't we? And I like working with small brushes versus big brushes. And we kind of all just paint in our own unique fashion, which I think is great. So if you see me doing something that is different than somebody else, that's why. And I wasn't professionally trained either. This is something I've just always done. I tend to just paint intuitively, I guess. Kind of let my brain shut off and that creative side of things just take in and take over. So I'm just going to try to blur these two together a little bit. So I have a gradation of color. Doing the same along this wing, just letting the two colors mix and blend a little bit. I'm using a burnt sienna. I'm sure it wasn't very funny at the time. This was, yes, burnt umber. That I am using here with a little bit of the gray color, the Payne's gray. Yeah, I enjoy watching too. I spend time watching different artists. My family kind of laughs at me sometimes because I'm like, I watched this one young man who does spray paint art, which I could never do some of the stuff that they do. But, you know, that's okay. We all have our own, we have our own ways of painting and doing things. And that's what makes art so fun and meaningful and different. What I might do will speak differently to someone than what you might do. Or, you know, somebody who's just picking it up for the first time. But it'll speak on a different level, is what I'm trying to say. But I think you get that. So. Thank you. I need a little bit more of that Van Dyke brown, darken. Hey, I'm live upstairs. I'm live. That's okay. Just wanted you to know. Show. I was watching this one artist. Oh, thanks, Robert. I was watching this one artist last night. Man, I don't know. The energy he had was just phenomenal. But he was really getting all over himself because he was struggling. He hadn't, as he put it, colored in a while. And I watched him quit one painting and start on another one in the midst. This was like, oh, I've done that, but I've never had that happen live. I felt for him. I felt so bad because you know what that's like. You struggle trying to get, you know, the what you have up in your brain down on paper, and it can be a real pain in your heart when you just can't get what you're trying to say onto the paper, you know? And sometimes a painting works and sometimes a painting doesn't work. For whatever reason, I've been known to do a painting a couple of different ways until I find the medium that the story wants to be told in. Sometimes the story is in watercolor, sometimes it's in acrylics. Sometimes it doesn't want to be told. And just figuring out, you know, sometimes it's just a photograph. I learned that from my daughter, actually. Because I would struggle and struggle and struggle. And she's like, Mom, maybe it just doesn't want you to tell people what's going on with it. Or maybe you just need to try it using something else. And she was right. I would try different mediums and different textures. There's a little bit of red in this, kind of going in here, a little reddish brown, and these wing feathers back here. I don't know if that's just from the sun or. So I'm just going to go in here and just kind of make some abstract feather shape. And with this straight brush. Just remembering where the wings go. I'm such a fool, yeah, such a fool. Yeah, I like that much, much better. A little touch of this brown in here where the gray is at. Mix a little bit. Yeah, that really helps a lot in there. I know it seems really bright. Yeah, that's looking really good. I'm really liking how that's coming out so far. So, get a little bit of orange, and a little bit of this red-brown, and I'm going to come in here and do some work on this beak. One thing with watercolor is it dries lighter than it goes on. So, if that's something you didn't know, that will help. You usually have to add more than one color or one layer of color. To get the achieved goal. So here I'm just gonna lay in a little bit of this bright yellow. It's a, what is that yellow called? That one is called candy yellow. And if you weren't here when I started, this is the set that I'm using. It's the Grabbie watercolor set. And I really do like this set a lot. It's really great. I've taken it plein air painting, and really, really liked the convenience of it, and all the colors. Matter of fact, I like to work on mineral paper when I'm doing plein air, and I did this one down in Corpus this last time. My sister and I just sat on the dock with my mom and watched the pelicans flying around and the birds, and we even saw some spoonbills out there. I have some really cool photos of that. So that was fun. And these Grabbie watercolors do really well on mineral paper. So that gives you that. It's just, it's a nice way to pass some time when you're just out and hiking and enjoying the nature. And I'm lucky my sister appreciates art and my art, and always wants yeah, this is watercolor, Robert. Sorry, I didn't look up and see all that. Yeah, where I grew up on the Back Bay area of Biloxi, and in Mississippi, and it wasn't that crowded. Of course, you know, we used to say nobody wants to come to Mississippi because, you know, we have the brown Mississippi Gulf Coast. So nobody ever really bothered with it, but now they have all the casinos there, and I don't live there now. We moved mom here to Texas where I live, because it just was too far to have her away. So okay, I'm just doing the lower part of his beak, keeping it fairly light. I'm using what color is that? If I can tell you, it's a kind of a fleshy tone. This is cinnamon, is what they call this color, but it's kind of a palish, not what I would expect cinnamon to look like. You know, we're so used to the cinnamon that comes in the jar, and this is definitely not that. But so I'm just adding just a little bit of this in here, and I'm going to fade it out with some more water on my brush, just a light amount of water on my brush, not a lot, because I've got a lot of wet paint in here right now, and I don't want it to start running and causing things to move. So okay. And I'll come in with some gouache, which is just a thicker watercolor type paint. It's more opaque, and I'll use that to put in some highlights and do the eye. I'm going to finish doing some work on the post, but overall, I'm pretty pleased with how it's looking. I'll go in and do some line work here in just a little bit. Once it's dried, I'll use these fine point archival ink liners that I have. I have them in a number of different sizes. So I'll use those at some point here when this is a little drier. I think I'm gonna just come in here real quick. I wanna add a little bit of blue under here. I'm gonna darken up just underneath this wing down into the seat where, yeah, just like that. Okay. And I do need to add a little bit of a darker basing. Don't go in there. Thanks, Robert. I appreciate that so much. I think. Yeah, I got a little water up in that. I'm just choosing the sharp edge of this tiny little brush. It's a I can't even read it. The writing is so small. It's a Giorgione G1885, and I don't know. It's just a little square, flat. And it's kind of the one I like to use a lot for working with wildlife, because I like the flat chisel that I can get with it and the shapes that I can get. So I was trying to darken this gray up a little bit more. Once the rest of this dries and lays flat again, I can come in and do some more pulling up but it's a little too wet right now. I should have mentioned I'm using a 300-pound watercolor paper, and this particular paper is by Canson, and I have it here with me. I left it with my students at the art center, but we have a project. They were learning how to do neurographic art using watercolor paper, so that was a lot of fun. I work with special needs adults that are on the spectrum, and they really love art. I do. I work with. I volunteer at a adult learning center. It's for handicapped and special needs adults, I started doing that after my brother passed away. He had Down syndrome and loved art and all kinds of things like that. And so, yeah, I do that. And they love, oh my gosh, they look forward to the days that I'm up there. It's really fun for them. It's fun for me too. That I will say it's a lot of fun. So it's very rewarding. Hi, Tony. Welcome. The Duck Army has arrived. Let's see, we're gonna add some dark reds to this post down here at the bottom. So we're just gonna get a few strokes of this red in just to deepen those browns up a little bit. And remember, like I said, the watercolor dries lighter, and so you may have to do two or three coats. I'm going to go in with some more red, but in a red-brown mixture, and just blend those up. Because this is the back side, the sun's coming across, well, down, but if you were, this would be the view that you would see if you were looking at the pelican. The angle that I took the photo at was directly straight on, so. Thanks for sharing, Robert. My dogs are sitting outside the door, scratching at the carpet, wanting to come in, and they cannot. They're not allowed. So I'm just giving this a coat. I could use a bigger brush. But like I said, I like using this small flat wash brush. Oh, that was a little orange. That's too orange. Need some more brown. There we go. It's all right. It wants to be that color. All right. The tide hadn't been out very long when I sat and watched these, so the post was still kind of wet. So it's kind of just doing like a stain over it. Not really. I'm just adding these transparent colors over the top of that dark brown mixture that I had put in. And then I had also scratched in with my razor blade to lighten some of these areas here. And so now that color makes those scratches pop through. How's it looking? Is it looking okay? I know what I'm seeing. I see a lot of brown. Oh, I'm gonna have to do something about that. It seems very brown. I think that's why I wanted to warm this, all this brown up with some orange rust color, because it just seems so dry. What do you think? Does that look good? I like that, Robert. That's really good. Sitting on the dock of the bay. Hey, Alexa, play Sitting on the Dock of the Bay.
You're sitting on the dock of the bay.
Hey. Here you go. Alexa, turn it up.
Sitting in the morning sun, I'll be sitting when the evening comes.
There you go.
Watching the ships roll in, then I watch them roll away again. Yeah, I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay,
wasting time. I miss those days.
I left my home in Georgia, headed for my family. Frisco Bay. I've had nothing to live for. It looked like nothing's gonna come my way.
So you're welcome.
On a darker bay, watching the tide roll away. I'm sitting on a darker bay, wasting time.
Change. So this is a little magic eraser, and I just want to come in on his beak here while this all dries, and I want to just kind of use it to lighten some of this yellow, because I'm thinking I laid too much color right there. So it just lifts enough without tearing the paper like an eraser would do, or leaving a mark. So I can use it to bring some of that color back. And the same here, I can come to the top of the head without using a razor blade, and I can use this to just slightly pull up some of that color. Any more requests? It's one of my favorite songs too, Tony.
In this world of ups and downs, my dreams all fall through. Things just don't work out no matter what I do. Disappointment haunts me through each lonely day. The world around us, I see it only shades away.
I'll be right back. I'm not going to meet you, but I'll be right back. Looking at this and feeling like I'm liking how it looks. Thinking I want to put some yellow highlights on. Head up here. Just a little. A little bit here in the wings. Yeah, I'm just using my brush on the tip and pulling the color in and through. Just keeping the tip flat. A little bit more yellow. Alexa, play Brown Eyed Girl.
Brown Eyed Girl by Van Morrison on Amazon Music.
I'm just going to come in here with a little bit of that yellow and touch it onto the brown.
Laughing and running, hey, skipping and jumping in the misty morning fog with our hearts that thumping in you. My brown eyed girl, you my brown eyed girl. And whatever happened to Tuesday and so.
I'm just feathering that out a little bit. I want to make it a little bit darker in here. And then along this outer edge, make it. Who is Maz? Is this someone that I should go and follow and learn from?
You have grown. Cast my memory back there a lot. Sometime we'll come think about it. Make a love in the green grass.
Drop her link. And I'll go check her out.
Sha la 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 la
need to take a look at my photo again. Oh, thanks, Tony. I like following other talented artists, so I love seeing what they're doing. And how they're doing it. You're never too old to learn, as far as I'm concerned. And, you know, art changes so much, but there's so many new things that come out that I honestly haven't a clue about. Because, you know, we get so tuned into what we do that we don't, we don't always branch out a little bit. And I like to learn how to branch out and do other things. So, I find learning from other artists can be really helpful. There might be an easier way for me to do something than the way I'm currently doing it, being self-taught, you know. So, drop her link and then I'll go and find her. So, I think I need to bring in a little of this gray right here at the mouth, the beak, where it joins. Just using the very edge of this to kind of feather in some gray shading where the mouth opens and closes. I don't know what that's called. So if you know, tell me. Because I don't know what it is. And then just a little bit of some of that gray in the underside, because it's not all one solid color. And it's going to have, you know, membrane and stuff like that, because this is the thin part, the part that opens up and creates the basket. That gathers all the fish. So it's going to have, you'll be able to see, if you ever watch them up close, you can see the, you can almost see the transparency of it. That's the word I'm looking for. Thanks, Josh. So, glad you can join us. So anyway, this is looking pretty good here, I think. Alexa, dismiss. Thank you. I was thinking I would try to add some touches of this brown up here just to help be able to see the tip of this better, because it's almost like why is it green? And when you see the wood or the post in the picture, it's really this very bright, verdant green. It's really, really pretty. And there's hardly any brown here near the top. Okay, you're going to probably hear my shepherd. She's a black shepherd, and she is a talker. And she's telling me very much how she wants to go out. So I have to see if my mother is available to put her outside. My mom lives with me. Okay, that's much better. I'm liking that slight brown over the top. I think I'm going to do that in here too, where the shadow's at. Yeah, there, that gives more of that wood feel. Do you think? Yeah, I think doing a wash over that green really helps it feel like it belongs. Yeah. I like that a lot. So, if you're just joining, I'm painting a pelican in watercolor using... Oh, thanks, Robert. That's really sweet. I really appreciate that. So, I'm working in watercolor. Using the Grabbie Watercolor set. You can buy, this is the 100 set, includes the metallic pearls, and I really like the results. This is what you can get from using that set, and that set was pretty inexpensive, I think, when I got it. I'm not sure what they run now, and I don't sell it. You can just go and buy it. It's just telling you, I like the product. I think they look really good, and they're a really good quality set. Great for traveling with too. But thank you very much, Robert. That was really kind. He is, isn't he, Tony? And let's see. I need some music requests. My brain's not thinking, and I can't figure out what I should listen to. Somebody wants to request some music to play, I'll put it on. I'm just going to add a little bit more of that blue in here. And yeah. Oh, you're so nice. You're very kind. Thank you, Robert. Just going in and doing a light touching of that teal. It's a kind of a minty teal color. Back in some of the places where I lost that. And it's laying over the top of those browns really nicely. So, thanks, Tony. Let's see here. What do you want? I need a smaller brush to work on the eye. And let's see, it's just their eyes are so funny because it's like as my daughter-in-law, she's from Greece, would say, they look like the evil eye. So it's white with the black dot in the center. And the evil eye, of course, is just, you know, it's white with a big blue dot in the center. Or at least that's the ones I've seen. So, not that we believe in any of that stuff, but it's a very large part of her upbringing because she was born and raised over there. But yeah, she's, my mom is hard of hearing, and so there's a great big discussion downstairs about which bathroom to use. I don't know why. Okay. This weekend we had our bathroom flood. And so everybody had to use the upstairs bathrooms. So funny. Amarillo by morning. Okay. Alexa, Amarillo by morning. I love George Strait. I was supposed to go to that concert years and years and years ago. And Alexa, play Amarillo by morning.
Amarillo by morning by George Strait. Amazon Music.
My husband, who was not my husband at the time, attended it, and we found out years later I was supposed to go, but I got sick, so we would have been there at the same time. Just weird, right? You know, and it was 5-6 years later where I actually met my husband. So, just a funny story. Everything that I got is just what I've got on. And my husband, he is a musician, plays just about everything you can imagine. Keyboard, guitar, electric guitar, acoustic guitar, drums, sings, even dances. My saddle in Houston broke my leg in Santa Fe. I'm going to have to put this eye in a couple of times before the white takes hold. I'll be looking for it when they pull that gate, and I hope that judge ain't lying. Have a real morning. On my mind. Amarillo by morning. So I'm just using some of that white to come in here and just add in some little tufts of feathers. Just keeping them short. Just trying to barely tap. And because this is watercolor gouache, it has a tendency, let's put it that way, to not dry white. So you get a few little bits of the undercolor shining through, which that's the only thing about, oh, listen to that one. It's awfully loud. Anyway, I forgot what I was saying. Da, da, da. Right. Let me bring this up a little bit to the camera so you can see it a little bit better. I can stand. She sure is a cutie, isn't she? I like how she's looking. Using the end of my brush to tap in some of that white. Filtered water, but it doesn't matter. You can use whatever you want. I just, I'm a cheapskate. We had some people over and left their water behind that they didn't finish. And rather than throw it away, I just recycle it. Cheyenne Frontier Days. That's... I'm going to try to lift this out because it's got a little bit of a yellow cast from where this brown dragged across my sleeve, where I'm just going to have to go in and add some of that sky blue and see if I can make that just disappear. And we love the rodeo. Used to being in Texas. Everybody loves rodeos. I think that fixed it. It's not so yellow now. You'll find me there with all the others. Just looking for love. Okay. Hi, John. Welcome to the live. Glad you can hang out. Just working on a little bit of watercolor. I'm still working out what day works the best to go live on, which days and what time for me. I'm finding that I think afternoons work the best. Generally, everybody is usually not here. But with spring break, I had my granddaughter who tends to... she's here, and my son, who is off during spring break, visiting, so. Yellow to the top of the beak here. And what you can't see is I have some lines that I drew that kind of tell me where I want my highlights to rest. So I knew this going in when I planned them. I got a ride in Denver all night. I call the house but no one answered. For the last 2 weeks no one's been home. I guess she's through with me. To tell the truth I just can't see what's kept the woman holding on this long. Saddles get cold. Not much too young to be
best ammo. All the cards are on the table with no ace left in the hole. Not much too young to feel this battle.
The little sparkly bits here and there. Not too crazy. Bob Ross.
You're my son over the rainbow. Like a turquoise, we see those out in rhinestones. Half stained glass, half neon glow. You color up my world. Every life feels like some old. Stuck into
right. Once we get enough white layered on there, we can add that final black dot.
You like green grass, blue skies. When I forget what love's supposed to look like, just takes one look in your eyes. You color up my world. Just takes one look in your eyes, you color up my world.
I'm glad you're enjoying the music. Yeah, I'm a good old Southern girl, so. What's the saying? Country fried and cornbread. That's this one.
But I still got neon in my veins. This gray hair don't mean a thing. I do my rocking on the stairs. You can't put this puzzle in a cage.
So, here, y'all probably find this funny. When I was in the military, I joined when I was 16. And graduated high school when I was 17, and the day after graduation, I was headed to Texas to go to boot camp in San Antonio, Texas, and The 6 foot tall, 100 pounds soaking wet southern girl. I cut my hair, which was as long as it is now, up to the nape of my neck, and had to listen to everyone tease me about my southern I finished the Pelican yesterday, and I thought I'd show you that real fast. It's a lot brighter than it truly is, but I think it came out really nice. So I'm going to be getting this one set up to be scanned and framed. Once it's scanned, I'll have prints available. Okay. So these are resin pieces.